Hi, this is Jacob Macias with CableWholesale.com. Last video, we introduced to you guys keystones and keystone wall plates. This video, we'd like to show you guys how to punch down your own Ethernet keystones. Let's take a closer look.
Okay, so what I have here is a cat cable. Now this guy is stripped down about an inch to reveal the twisted pairs on the inside. Now what I like to do is fan them out in the basic order on how I will be crimping them down. And on this particular keystone, all of ours are the same. It will be in the top left will be orange stripe. Bottom left is blue stripe. Top right is brown stripe. And then bottom right is the green and green stripe. Now, every keystone out there is a little bit different on how they pin out. So you'll always want to take a look at the sticker on the side. And also always use the industry standard B color coding, which is what we're using here. And once you figure that out, you can fan them out in the correct positions. It just makes it a little bit easier when you're ready to crimp them down. So I'm ready to go. I'm just going to seat this down into the cavity here. And I go to work just pressing them into their corresponding holes. Now, I know these by heart, but if you were to look at the side, you'd see they're lining up in the correct order. The colors are all good. And just seat them down. This one's a little twisted. Now, the reason I like to seat them down in here beforehand is that I can come through at one pass and with my tool later on and just crimp, press them all down. It makes it a little bit easier. Do one job at a time. So there they are, all crimped or pulled down snugly into the 110 slots. I get my tool, and this 110 tool features a blade on one side. Now that blade, you always want to keep it to the outside of the keystone. It will actually crimp up against the outer bumper that's on the keystone, and it will cut the excess copper off. Now if you press nice and hard on that outer edge of the blade, it will pinch real nicely, and it should be easier later to pull off. Now, for the other side, switch the blade over and crimp each of these down. All right, one more. Okay, I'll crimp down, and these should fall off nicely. Yeah. Okay, done. And that's the handiwork. Nice and easy. Put the cap on for aesthetics. And you got a 110 keystone.
And there you guys have it. How to punch down your own 110 style Ethernet jacks for a professional looking install in your homes or offices. If you'd like to give this a try yourself, please head over to our website, cablewholesale.com/110punch. We have all the supplies you're going to need. Until next time, take care.